Hi there. Thank you for joining me for another video of skeletal muscles. On this video, we will briefly look at how the muscle fiber arrangement can give us useful clues of their names and the muscles in general. Let's get started. So as you might remember from our earlier chapter, all skeletal muscles consist of bundles of fibers known as fascicles. Their arrangement may vary, which gives rise to the muscles with various different shapes. And that is not all. This also can have an effect on muscles' functional characteristics. So the fiber orientation is something that we definitely want to look at. And there are five common patterns of arrangement that I want to discuss with you just briefly. Let's start with the circular ones. And the example that I have picked here is the orbicularis oris muscle, so this round muscle around the mouth. And we see that in circular ones, the fibers are arranged in concentric circles. How about convergent ones? Let's look at that. In convergent fiber arrangements, we have a broad origin that then converge into one insertion. And the example of that, which we have here, is the pectoralis major muscle, so our most prominent chest muscle. Let's talk about fusiform arrangement. Here we have biceps brachii muscle as an example of it, and it is a good one to use as a sample. So these are spindle-shaped muscles with fibers that run parallel to each other and fuse together at the ends. Next, I would like us to look at parallel arrangement of the muscle fibers. And here we have fibers that run to the same direction of each other, following the long axis of a strap-like muscle. And a good example of that would be the sartorius muscle, which runs from the lateral hip to the medial thigh. Then, I would like to introduce you to the pennate muscles, where the unifying characteristic is the short fibers attaching obliquely to a central tendon, which runs for the length of the muscle. And there are a few subcategories of these. Let's look at those in a little more detail. In unipennate muscle, the fibers attach only to one side of the tendon. And as an example of this could be extensor digitorum longus muscle of the lower limb. Then bipennate muscle, the muscle fibers insert from the opposite sides of the tendon. And here a nice example of this is a rectus femoris muscle of the thigh. Finally, the last one that I want to include is the multi-pennate arrangement of the muscle fibers. Here, like in the example of the deltoid muscle that wraps around the shoulder rather superficially, these fibers attach to one tendon, but they have this feather-like arrangement, if you wish. So those are our five common patterns of a muscle fiber arrangement that I wanted to introduce you on this video. And now that we have reviewed these, and as we already talked about naming of the muscles, I think that we are ready to start reviewing the major skeletal muscles of the body. It will be a lot to take in, but just go through these in steps, giving yourself time to really look at and study them.